printing on and off contact. With very, very few exceptions, printing on contact will have a delayed snap off, and this will cause some of the ink to get stuck inside the mesh threads. When you lift up, it will peel that ink back and it will actually resist you being able to pull the screen off. In some extreme cases, say a low mesh, a 40 metric, 110 in inch measurements with a thick white ink, you can hear it particularly with automatic machines where they're running a little too fast and with not enough off contact, and they're not actually allowing the squeegee to press the ink through, and the ink gets laid down and it stays in position. You'll hear it, it'll pop as that actually comes up and makes kind of a slurping pop noise as it comes up. You can hear this from a fairly good distance off of an automatic machine because it happens every time it comes in and it tries to, literally the machine is forcing it to peel up and out of the ink. Well, that actually causes a fairly customer obvious problem because they will pick out that there's something wrong with the print, and it's usually referred to as orange peel because it does look very much like the peel of an orange in an uneven surface, and it's caused by the ink coming up, getting pulled back by the mesh and getting stuck surface wise, and as it pulls up, little strings of ink pop off and they fold back down inside the ink and they cause this texture to form on the surface. Obviously not a positive most of the time. Now proper off contact will have instantaneous snap off, and what will happen is that as the squeegee travels along, the screen will peel out of the ink as it travels along, and it will give you a nice instant snap off and a nice clean sharp print. There is one other issue to be aware of that is in conjunction with this, and that is whether you need to flood or not, whether you're going to do a fill flood or a normal flood, and whether or not what you're doing can cause an overflood. So we're going to specifically talk about flooding too much or putting too much ink into the screen mesh, and this is problematic most of the time with thin, watery inks. And as you come across and you flood, a lot of times you'll actually form a bubble down at the bottom, and of course as you come down on the product, that bubble squishes off from the side and it smears the product. I see this with Plastisol, especially with some of the thinner to medium body Plastisols, using a 156 or a 60 mesh, or up to a 60 mesh in count by centimeter, and they're literally just printing so much ink down that it, and flooding enough so that the ink forms a bubble, it squishes off from the sides, and it causes problems with the print. Causes the edges to be fuzzy, and then of course this ink will smear along the edge. A lot of times you can see little feathery edges, or it will be smeared along the edge as if the image weren't clear. A lot of times this, the mesh is too low, there's not enough off contact, and there's too much ink going down, and you might often be over flooding. This is also something that happens whenever you're printing very, very small dots on a product that is porous, like a t-shirt. So if you happen to print and the very, very small dot happens to be too small and it actually fits inside the weave of the thread and it doesn't actually touch anything, it is not uncommon for that dot of ink to stay along the bottom of the screen. It doesn't actually touch any of the product at all. It lifts up, and then of course that bubble stays there. Whenever you flood and print again, now you have a double dot, and if that happens to catch a thread the next time, then that particular dot is going to get a double layer of ink and it's going to have a modded, uneven surface. This is one of the reasons why I'm careful about telling customers to not try and chase too small of a dot pattern, because depending on how high quality the shirt is, it is not uncommon for the weave of the shirt to actually have enough holes in it to match the small size of the smallest dots, and then it actually ends up with a double dot on some some areas, and of course it's inconsistent, which causes us problems.